Hello. In this video, we're going to show you how to connect Modbus RTU and I/O data to a SCADA using an ioThinx 4510. For more information on this process, you can refer to Chapter 4, Software Tools, and the ioThinx 4510 Series User Manual. Now let's get started. First, you need to enable the Modbus RTU Master Service in the Security Settings page. Next, go to the Serial Port page to set up your communication interface. Set the mode, baud rate, parity, data bits, stop bits, and flow control for your RTU device. Next, enable the device with the corresponding device ID. The ioThinx 4510 supports up to 8 devices for RS-485 two-wire connection, and up to 4 devices for RS-232 and RS-422. Last, we need to add a profile to collect the data and map it to the internal register. To add a profile, enter the profile name, point type, start address, length, and scan rate. Then we need to map the data to the internal register, where the ioThinx 4510 will store your RTU device data. Define the internal register type, start index, swapped value, and exception code storage index for the word internal register. After setting up, you can verify your settings by checking the internal register from the internal register page. A green bar means that the internal register location is being used. You can click on it to see the information and define name for the register. To get the data from the register to your SCADA, you can use Modbus, RESTful API, MQTT, or SNMP. Now, let's take a look at our SCADA, and we'll be able to see the data from our VFD and IOs. Now, as you can see, when we change the frequency on our VFD and change our IO status, we'll be able to see the corresponding status updated in our SCADA. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in our ioThinx IIoT Starter Kit, you can visit our site for more information.